ignition. The first topic is about the ignition system. What is this ignition system? When you start your car, let's say this is the car key. When you insert the car key, we call that ignition switch. Kung saan pumapasok na susi, that is the ignition switch. When you turn the key to the right, the first sound that you hear is the sound of the starter. That is the starter. Where is the starter? This is the starter. So when you turn the key to the right, the first sound that you hear is the sound of this starter. And then, you press the gasoline pedal, that is the engine. Our lesson for tonight is about the ignition system. Meaning how come when you put the key inside the ignition switch and then you turn the key to the right, bakit umaandar ang makina? So when we say ignition system, ano ang nagpapaandar sa makina? So for the first time in our lecture, we will be studying the engine, piece by piece. From the car key up to the engine, kung paano siya umaanda. So later on, when you become a driver, hindi lang kayo marunong mag-drive, at the same time, you also understand your engine. There are many parts needed before you can start the car. Like for instance, can you start the car without the key?
No.
Walang susi. Can you start the car?
Yes.
That is why car knappers can easily car knap your car even if the key is with you. So this is not important. Can you start the car without the ignition switch? Where you insert the car key, that is the ignition switch. Without the ignition switch, can you start the car?
Yes.
How? By direct method of starting. Irerekta. Can you start the car without the starter? Ito. This is the starter. Can you start the car without this?
Yes.
How? By pushing. So the car key, the ignition switch, the starter, these are just minor parts of the ignition system. They are not that important. Even without this, you can still drive your car. However, there are four principal parts. If one is missing, no way that you can start the engine. So we will be discussing all these principal parts, one by one, piece by piece, in detail, so you understand your engine. What do you think is the most important part of the car, in which it is the number one principal part, without which you cannot even hear a sound? Like in the radio, without that there is no sound coming from the radio. Sa mga cellphone niya, pag low button, you cannot go. What is that? The battery. So this is the most important part of the car, the battery. Why important? Because the battery is the one supplying electrical current not only to the starter, but to the different parts of your vehicle which needs electricity. So without the battery, there is no electricity. Without electricity, no way that you can start the engine. Like at home, even if you have a beautiful house, complete with all these modern appliances, computers, TV sets, refrigerator, these are all useless the moment there is brownout. The same thing is true in your car. Even if you have a brand new car, complete, if the battery is not there, it is just a piece of junk. It is useless. So, since the battery is so important, then in your case, as a car owner and driver at the same time, you should know everything about this battery. Because unless you understand this battery, it might give you a big headache later on. Remember, every time you drive the car, the first thing you do, you start. Every time you start, you deal with this battery. And this is where you will get embarrassed. Especially if you are a young driver, you are dating your girlfriend for the first time, you are so excited, imagine your girlfriend is now seated inside the car with you. And then at the middle of the road, you start your car and don't start due to weak battery. One of the many advantages of driving a manual transmission, which is not present in the automatic car, if the battery is weak, you can still start that car by pushing. Who will push that car? Your girlfriend will push that car for you. Hindi nasasakay sa iyo yan. Pagputulakin mo lang pala siya. Yan. This is a sample of an ordinary battery. I'm sure nakakita na kayong car battery. We will study this battery piece by piece. How they make the battery, the components needed to make this battery, how they produce electricity out of this battery. So that later on, when you drive your car, if it won't start, and if the battery is the problem, you will know what to do. The first thing that you should know about this battery is the voltage. We have 6 volts, 12 volts, 24 volts. Why important to know the voltage? Because if your battery is 12 volts, every electrical part should follow the voltage of your battery. Like at home, if your a television set is 220 volts, you plug mo sa 220 volts outlet. If it is 110 volts, you plug mo sa 110 volts. Otherwise, you have to use a transformer. Like in your case, after finishing driving lesson with Socialites, and then you bought a second-hand car, upon delivery, you notice there is no stereo cassette. There is no sound system. Well, you cannot imagine yourself driving the car every day without any sound system. So immediately, you go to Banawe, which is the car accessory center of the Philippines, where you can buy everything in Banawe Street. You are buying a small, cheap stereo cassette. Pabili nga ako ng car stereo kamo. And the first thing that the seller will ask you is, ilang volts ba ang kotse niyo? Yung baterya niyo, ilang volts ba? Maiwan ko. Ikaw bibili ko lang kaninang umaga yan. Ay, they cannot give you. Because if your battery is 12 volts, they will give you 12 volts stereo cassette. If it is 6 volts, 6 volts. The same thing whenever you buy headlights, tail light, stop light, signal light, all electrical parts should follow the voltage of your battery. Like this one. By just looking at the sample, how many volts is this? You count the number of cups. Takip niya. Time is 2. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Time is 2. 12 volts. Yeah. If there are only 3 holes, time is 2. 6 volts. If there are 12 holes, 12 holes sila, time is 2. 24 volts. Why time is 2? Because for every hole, for every cup, there is one cell. For every cell, you can produce 2 volts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cells times 2, 12 volts. At present, all our late model and brand new cars are now using 12 volts batteries. It's only the old cars made in the 1960s, 1970s, up to the early 80s that are still using 6 volts batteries. Like whenever you drive around, when you see this old Volkswagen Beetle, 1975, 82, 84, 85, mga 6 volts lahat yan. But when you see this brand new late model, that beautiful Volkswagen Beetle, modern na yan, 12 volts na yan. How come even the car manufacturers decided to replace all the 6 volts batteries to 12 volts. What are the differences between these two? If you are an old driver, experiencing driving both vehicles back in 1960s and compare them with vehicles present now, instantly you can feel, you can see the difference between these two. How? Observe whenever you drive your car. For 1 hour driving, pag namatay makina, start, ang lakas mag-start, ang dali-dali, kasi 12 volts ang battery na. Pag 6 volts, every time you start, you are always praying. Start. You could hardly hear the sound of the start there. Ang mga kotse kaya ni start. Ang lakas 12 volts na nila. Pag, at night driving, when you use 12 volts battery, you put on the headlights, you can see everything in front of you. Ang liwala, kasi 12 volts. Pag 6 volts, mag-flashlight ka na lang. Ang labo-labo nila, especially nowadays, in rainy season. With 12 volts battery, you drive at night, you put on the headlights, paliwanag ng ilaw, if somebody is crossing the road, you tap the horn, bubus yun na ka. Nagagalit lahat ng mga tao pag bubus yun na ka. Kasi nagbibingi sila. Dahil 12 volts yan. Pag 6 volts, sigawan mo na lang. Para marinig ka nila. Kaya wala na lahat yung mga 6 volts na yan. Outside this battery, this box, we call this battery casing. It is made of plastic or fiberglass. On top of your battery, nakikita niya, yan. We call this battery post, poste. We have 2 posts. One is positive post, the other one is negative post. Something is attached to the post, ito yon, yon. Pag wala yun, ito, yun, yun. We call this battery terminal. Battery terminal. Something is attached to the battery terminal, yon. We call this battery cable. It is made of plastic, wires inside, but covered with plastic. Since you have 2 posts, positive and negative, there are also 2 terminals and 2 cables. One cable is positive, the other one is negative cable. The positive cable is attached to the positive post, and the negative cable is attached to the negative post. Yung mga takip na ito, we call this battery cover. Battery cover. Yung mga bilog-bilog na ito, ha, yung nasa gilid niya, battery connectors. If I remove the battery cover, remove the battery connectors, and open this wire, and you look inside, what do you think is inside the battery? Nakakita na ba kayo car battery na bukas? If you open this, there is nothing inside other than this, yan. Nakita ninyo. Ayun nyo. O pag binunod ko yan, yan. Ang loob yan. Yan. We call this battery plates. Which is made of screen, but covered with lead, with chemicals. Yan. So section by section yan. Kung anin yan, yan. Pag binunod ko isa-isa, ganyan yan. So inside this battery, it is just full of this one, plates. We call this battery plates. Since you have 2 posts, positive and negative, there are also 2 sets of plates inside. Half of the plates are positive, half of them are negative. Yeah. The arrangement of the plates inside the sapasinyo is positive, negative, alternate chat, positive, dekala, negative. Now, if the first plate is positive and the next one is negative, hindi pwedeng magtikip ang positive sa negative plates. Pag nagtikip yan, what happened? Like pag pinagtikip mong babae sa kalalaki, anong nangyari? Ay, hindi naman baby ka agad. Magka-ground muna kayo. Pag pareho kayong grounded, magkaka-baby kayo. So, hindi kayo dapat nagkakatikip. You have to separate by putting something in between. It's like all of them. We call that battery separator. It's made of plastic to separate the positive from the negative plates. So in between the positive and negative, that is the separator. Because without the battery separator, magdidikit ang positive sa negative. Pag nagdikit yan, magkakaroon ng ground. The moment there is ground, no way that you can produce electricity. Kaya nakita niyo dalawang positive, no? Yung isa positive, kabila negative. Positive, negative. Yan. Pag nakapasok na sila sa loob, nakakonect yan sa itaas yung battery connector. Now, to determine which one is positive or negative, ito na lang nakalutan yung positive. So, if this is the positive plate post, below, lahat ng positive plate is connected to the positive post. If that's the negative post, lahat ng ilalim ng plate sa negative, nakakonect sa negative post. That's all inside the battery. It is just made of plates, positive and negative. In between, you have the plastic battery separator. And yet, you put that in your car, start, it won't start. Why? There is no electricity yet. Although it's a complete battery, there is no electricity yet. To produce electricity out of this complete battery, you still lack one ingredient. What is that? Water. Lalagyan natin ang tubig yan. Bubuksan niya, lalagyan ang tubig, naka-plastic yan. In the battery, we use two kinds of water. What we call it electrolyte. The other one is distilled water. What is the difference between these two? Electrolyte and distilled water. Electrolyte, this is made of acid plus water. Yung acid, yung pag tinapon sa mukha mo, natutunaw ang mukha mo. Acid yun. That is the mixture of electrolyte. It is made of acid plus water. Whereas distilled water, this is 100% water, but distilled or purified. Since the battery is brand new, and you just need water to produce electricity, which of the two are you going to use? Is it electrolyte or distilled water? If your battery is brand new, you use electrolyte. Pagbagong baterya. However, after using the battery for several months, and you need to add water, then you cannot add electrolyte anymore. You only add distilled water. How come you cannot add electrolyte? Because electrolyte is made of acid and water. If every time you need water, you use electrolyte, the acid contents will exceed the water contents. So you will destroy, you will melt the battery. So you only add distilled water. However, if every time you need water, you use distilled water, after several months, everything inside is all distilled water. There is no more electrolyte. There is no more acid. So one early morning, you start your car. The normal sound that you hear every time you start is like this. Start. If the battery is strong, that's always the sound. If everything inside is all plain distilled water, there is no more electrolyte, there is no more acid, one day, you start your car, the sound would be like this. Start. Mahina na ang baterya. So what you do? You bring the car to the battery shop and have it checked. And the battery man will tell you the problem, sir. The problem, ma'am, is weak solution. Mahina na tubig. Everything inside is all plain distilled water. So to regain back the power of the battery, what he will do now is he will drain the battery out. Itatapon lahat ng tubig. And only then, he will use another electrolyte. So you only use electrolyte first if it's brand new. Second, every time you change the water, use electrolyte. But if you just add water, you only add distilled water. Okay? So, nakabot yan. Bawat isang putas yan, isang ganito, puputoy niya. The battery is now 100% complete. And yet, you put that in your car, start. Still going to start. Why? Although the battery is complete, there is no electricity yet. To produce electricity out of those of this complete battery, you have to charge the battery a little bit by using an electric charger. You plug it through the power of Meranto. For the first few minutes charging, you are now producing energy. Energy. In your high school subject, if you remember, they ask you to memorize to define many words. How do you define energy? The capacity and the ability to do work, that is energy. We have many kinds of energy, and what are these? The plates, which is made of chemicals, will react with the electrolyte, which is also made of chemicals. Chemicals reacting against chemicals, you are now producing chemical energy. But you don't need chemical energy. What you need is electrical energy. You keep on charging through the power of Meranto, which is electricity. That chemical energy will be transformed into an electrical energy. How do you know if there is electrical energy inside this battery? One way to do that is to get a piece of cable and then grind both poles. What do you normally see? Spark. The moment there is a strong spark, that means the battery is strong. There is enough electrical energy stored inside this battery. Like this one. Even if I keep on grinding, not a single spark is visible because there is no electrical energy inside this battery. This is a dead battery. Sira na ang battery nito. Kaya nga nandito na yun. Kasi hindi na pwedeng gamitin. So the point now is, the moment you become a driver and driving your car every day, every morning the first thing you do, you start. Every time you start your car, the normal sound is like this. But this time, you start your car, the sound that you hear is not a starting sound. The sound is ayaw mag-start. Start. Wala kay problema. So what you do, what's the problem here? To know the problem, you open the hood. You go to your battery. You get a piece of cable. And then, grind both poles. Ang lakas-lakas mag-spark. Grind. Malakas mag-spark. What's the meaning of that? If there is a strong spark, the battery is strong, start. If the battery is strong, and yet you don't hear the sound of the starter, what is the problem of your vehicle? Yung starter ang ready to race. Remember, ang nagpapayikot sa starter, ang baterya. So, pag malakas ang baterya, strong enough to rotate the starter, and yet, you don't hear the sound of the starter, the problem is the starter. Ayaw ikot. So, you have to bring the car to the electrical shop. How can you bring it there? You are inside your garage. You just start the car by
pushing.
Ngayon, if early morning you start your car, put the start, and then you want to know the problem, you open the hood, you got your battery. You don't have to be a mechanic to know that. It is just simple troubleshooting. Oh, you grind both poles. There is a weak spark. Grind. Ang hina niya mag-spark. What is the problem? The battery is the problem. Mahina siya. So you have to bring the car to the battery shop. How can you bring it there? By pushing. So that is how they make the battery, how they produce electricity out of this battery. But in your case, you are just a newly learned driver. You may be asking this question. Ano bang pakialam ko kung paano ginawa ang baterya niya? Bakit kailangan ninyong i-discuss sa amin yan? Nag-enroll ako sa Socialites, hindi naman para gumawa ng baterya. Nag-enroll ako dyan para mag-drive. You are correct. Your concern is not how they make the battery, because you can just go to the battery shop, buy another battery, and prepare the battery. That is not your concern. Your concern as a driver is how to use this battery. Because unless you know how to use this battery, it will give you a big headache every day. Remember, every time you start your car, the first thing you do is, every time you start, you need to start. In the Philippines, batteries are only guaranteed a maximum 1 year warranty. It costs around 2,500 pesos to buy one small battery. If the price is 2,500 and the warranty is 12 months, 95% on the 13th month siraya. It covers only the months of warranty. Like whenever you buy a brand new cell phone or brand new cell phone battery, bibili ka. Mas ang warranty nila 2 months na. The most is 3 months. Ang mga cell phone battery natin hindi nagtatagal kasi 2 months na sira na. Lalo na yung mga Class A, mga hindi original. So, knowing fully well that unless you know how to maintain this battery, unless you check this regularly, taon-taon magpapalit ka ng baterya. 2.5 ng 2.5. If you are a rich guy, what's 2,500? But it's supposed to last at least 1 year. Because the warranty is 1 year. And if worst come to worst, at hindi ka marunong mag-drive at hindi ka mag-checkin, buwan-buwan masisira yan. Buwan-buwan magpapalit ka ng baterya every month, 2,500. And do not think that because it is guaranteed for 1 year, every month that you destroy it, automatically they will replace it. No way. In any good that you buy, you are given this warranty certificate. This good is guaranteed for 1 year on conditions. You have to follow the conditions. If you don't, then it voids the warranty. So, as a car owner, how can you extend the lifespan of your battery? So instead of replacing it every 1 year, you just replace it every 1 year and a half or every 2 years' time. So you save money, at the same time, you extend the lifespan of your battery. Is that possible? Yes, if you know how. And you know very well, the first duty of a driver is see to it that your car is always in tip-top condition. Because the safety of your family depends upon the maintenance of your vehicle. Kaya nga, it's not that easy to own a vehicle. There is a big responsibility. Unless you check your car every day, araw-araw tulak dito, araw-araw tulak dyan, tulak. Wala na lang kayong ginawa kundi magtutulak na magtutulak. And most often, the problem is the battery. So how can you preserve the condition of the battery? How can you extend the lifespan of your battery? What? The number one enemy of any battery is lack of water. Without water, your battery will not last for 1 month. And if you destroy the battery due to lack of water, it is not covered in the warranty. Because if you look at the warranty certificate, it is printed there, this battery is guaranteed for 1 year on condition. And the first condition is very clear. Always keep this battery with water. That's the first condition. Dapat palaging may tubig yan. If you are in Manila, that is not a problem. Every day when you go to your school, when you go to your office, when you buy gasoline, when you go to the gas station, you can always ask the gasoline boy to check everything. Much more the battery water. And they will even give you free distilled water without paying a single cent. If you are in Manila. Now, if you are in the province where there are no gas stations, no battery shops, and there is no distance.